Water. We can keep going.
Thank you.
Zuko appeared unexpectedly, claiming to have had a change of heart and offering to help. But after all that had happened, no one trusted him. No one, that is, except Toph, who knew Aang needed a firebending teacher. So she left under the cover of night to find Zuko and bring him back.
Thank you. Thank you. wrong Zuko, but he accidentally burned her feet, causing her to flee. As she returned to the Air Temple, the ground began to shake.
It's Combustion Man. He's after us again!
This guy just won't quit.
He will if me and my trusty boomerang have something to say about that. More dangerous than ever.
Never seen firebending like that.
All right. know how to get an angle on him. Yeah, boomerang! Oh, boomerang.
With that battle, Prince Zuko had finally proven himself, not only to the Avatar and his friends, but to himself. He had come to realize that no one can be given honor. One must earn it for oneself. And at that moment, he chose to do what was right, to play his part in ending the war. The Avatar himself came to a realization. My nephew was meant to be his firebending teacher, because more than most, Prince Zuko knew how easy it was to hurt the people you love. While the others were less certain of Zuko's change of heart, they followed the wishes of the Avatar, and he joined their group. Soon, Zuko and Aang went to the Temple of the Sun Warriors, where they danced with dragons. They learned the real secret of firebending, that it is energy and life. Sokka, meanwhile, became increasingly concerned about his father and the others taken prisoner by the Fire Nation. Zuko said they were likely being held at a terrible place called Boiling Rock and attempted to dissuade Sokka from doing anything rash. But of course, now it was Sokka who felt he needed to regain his honor. Zuko knew how he felt and offered to help.
Did you listen?